children, we would dream of Christmas morn. And all the gifts and toys we knew we'd find. But we never realized a baby boy one blessed night gave us the greatest gift of our lives. We heard the reason that he gave his life. We were the reason that he suffered and died to a world that was lost. He gave all he could give to show us the reason to live. As the years went by, we learned more about gifts and the giving of ourselves and what that means. On a dark and cloudy day, a man hung crying in the rain because of love, because of us. And we were the reason that he gave his life. We were the reason that he suffered and died to a world that had reason to live. And I finally found the reason for living. You see, it's in giving every part of my heart to him. So in all that I do, every word that I say, I'll be giving my all just for him. For him. We are the reason that he gave his life. We are the reason that he suffered and died. Into a world that was lost, he gave all he could give to show us the reason to live. I'd like you to sing that little chorus with me, if you would, please. We are the reason that he gave his life. We are the reason that he suffered and died. And into a world that was lost, he gave all he could give to show us, you and me, the reason to live. Let's try it together, shall we? Here we go.
We are the reason that he gave his life.
That he suffered and died.
We are the reason that he suffered and died.
To a world that was lost.
To a world that was lost. He gave all he could give.
To show us the reason.
Show us the reason to live.
Let's try it once again.
We are the reason that he gave his life. We are the reason that he suffered and died. To a world that was lost, he gave all he could give. Show what's the reason to live.
And I want to thank you for your patience this afternoon. I tell you, sometimes you get a little bit spoiled. I'm used to having seven other people on stage with me, my group. And we wanted to come down and see you guys, and there was just no way we could fly everybody down here. And so we kind of had to decide whether we wanted to either come solo or not at all. And I want to thank you for making it such a wonderful experience for me. I never thought of myself as a singer anyway. That's why it's nice when you have seven other people on stage making all this noise, you know. It starts rocking and kicking. They can't hear your voice anyway, you know. I never thought of myself as a singer. In fact, the only reason I started singing in the first place was because I couldn't get anyone else to sing my songs. I was a songwriter and a piano player. And I never forget the first time I was invited to sing someplace. I thought the guy was kidding, first of all. I was at a music conservatory, and I was majoring in classical piano. And this fellow came up to me. He was a youth pastor. He was a friend of mine, but he was a youth pastor there in Baltimore where I was going to school. He came up to me between classes one day and said, "Dave, what are you doing this Sunday after the evening worship service?" I said, "I don't know." He said, "Well, we're going to have a little youth social, a little youth get-together over at this lady's house. Why don't you come and do like 30 or 40 minutes of your own music, talk about how you write your music, share a little bit, that kind of thing." I thought he was kidding. I said, "You want me to sing for 30 minutes in front of your kids? What, are you going to pass out Dramamine at the door? I can't sing." And he looked at me, and he told me something I never forgot. And I'd like to share it with you. He looked at me and he said, "David," he said, "God does not care how you sing. Doesn't matter to him whether you're the greatest singer that ever lived or whether you just kind of grunt along, you know? God does not care how you sing. God cares why you sing." And if you'd have said to me back then that I was going to be doing what I'm doing now, touring the world, doing concerts, making records, singing, no way, man. Having Rambo flashbacks or something, there's no way. I can't sing. But you see, God had things in mind for me I could never have in my wildest fantasies have ever come up with. And I had gifts and talents and abilities I didn't even know I had. And I share all that with you because I know that there are a lot of you here today with a lot of insecurities yourself. You look around yourself and you see other people that seem to be so talented and so gifted and have it so together. And then you look at yourself in the mirror and you just don't feel like you're as good as other people. Ever feel that way? You know, you look at yourself in the mirror and you think you're just not as talented as you need to be. Are you not pretty enough? Or you're not talented enough? Or you're not gifted enough? Or you don't know enough? Or you're too far behind? Or you're just losing it. So you look around and the more you keep talking to yourself, the more you start believing yourself. And before you finish, you've convinced yourself that you're nothing, going nowhere, and that you just don't matter. Ever feel that way? Yeah. Well, I have a million times. Let me tell you something. That regardless of how you think about yourself or how you view yourself, I want you to listen to me because I mean this with all my heart. God made you just as special as he made me, every one of you. Just as special as he made me, just as special as he made anyone else on this planet. And gave you talents and abilities that you may not even know you have, you know? And put you here for a reason. Every one of you. A fabulous reason. A lot of you, if you knew what God had in mind for your life, man, you'd be freaking. You'd freak out. You couldn't deal with it. That's why God doesn't tell you everything all at once. Yeah, he doesn't want all the Christians freaking out at once, you know? He says, it'll be cool. I'll tell you when you get there. It's true. So the next time you feel like that you're not as good as somebody else, or that you're too far behind, or you're nothing, or that you don't matter, I want you to remember what I've told you, because I believe it with all my heart. And you are the reason Jesus Christ gave his life. Yeah, you who think you don't matter, that you're not important. You are the reason he suffered and died. If David Meese had never been born, if all the people that are here tonight except for you had never been born, and you in fact were the only one alive today, I still believe Jesus Christ still would have gone through all that he went through and done all that he did, because he loves you. You and all your insecurities and all your fears and self-doubts and all your hang-ups. Into a world that was lost, he gave all he could give to show you not the reason to die, but to show you the reason to live. That's right. So may we all rather be led by him, the one who made us. I want you to sing that chorus again. This time I want you to put in the words, I am the reason that he gave his life. I am the reason that he suffered and died. And into a world that was lost, he gave all he could give to show me, the reason to live. Let's sing it together, shall we? I am the reason. Think about it as you do. Here we go.
I am the reason that he gave his life. I am the reason that he suffered and died. To a world that was lost, he gave all he could give.
To show me the reason.
To show me the reason to live.
And one more time, we are the reason.
We are the reason that he gave his life. We are the reason that he suffered and died. To a world that was lost, he gave all he could give. Show us the reason to live.
Believe me when I tell you.
He is my reason.
God bless you.